Hello everyone, I'm Annapurna from ClearTax, and in this video, let me give you details about the Central Tax Circular No. 141/2020 that was passed on 24 June 2020. It clarifies about the applicability and calculation of interest and late fee relaxation for any delay in GSTR 3B filing announced as a relief measure during COVID. Firstly, with respect to taxpayers having aggregate turnover of more than Rs 5 crore in the previous financial year, the return periods from February to April 2020 got an extension up to 24 June 2020 through the conditional late fee waiver and staggered interest for any delay. The due date for May 2020 was actually extended up to 27 June 2020 without any late fee or interest if filed before this date. The due dates for June 2020 and July 2020 were not extended but will get a reduction in late fee for any delay. If these returns are filed after the specified dates but before 30th September 2020, then late fee shall apply from the original due date up to the actual date of filing but subject to a maximum of Rs 500 per return. In case of nil returns, no late fee shall apply if returns are filed before 30th September 2020. As far as interest is concerned for the delay in filing GSTR 3B, only for the months from February to April 2020, no interest would be charged if GST dues were paid before 4th April, 5th May and 4th June for February, March and April months respectively. Otherwise, interest applies from the next day onwards at a reduced rate of 9% per annum up to the date of actual payment if paid before 24 June 2020. If filed after 24 June, then interest is charged in a staggered manner till 24 June and thereafter interest at 18% per annum will apply from 25th June till the date of actual filing. Secondly, with respect to taxpayers having aggregate turnover of less than or equal to Rs 5 crore in the previous financial year, although the due dates never got extended except for August 2020, no late fee or interest will apply if they file GSTR 3B on or before the dates displayed on your screen, which vary according to the state or union territory in which your business is situated. For the two lists of the states in category A and category B, click on the link given in the description below. However, if there is any delay beyond these specified dates, but the filing is completed before 30th September 2020, then late fee shall apply from original due date up to the actual date of filing, subject to a maximum of Rs 500 per return. In case of nil returns, no late fee shall apply for filing done before 30th September 2020. Likewise, interest at reduced rate of 9% per annum shall apply if filing is done after these dates until the actual date of filing if a taxpayer files on or before 30th September 2020. If filed after 30th September, then interest applies in a staggered manner till 30th September and thereafter interest at 18% per annum will apply from 1st October up to the actual date of filing. There were three other Central Tax Circulars, No. 136, 137 and 138 that were passed under GST to clarify about the extension that was given for various other GST compliances. These include filing of refund application, filing of LUT under GST by exporters, extended validity of e-waybills, treatment of advance forfeited under GST, cancellation of business contracts under GST and implications, etc. An IRP or insolvency resolution professional has to obtain GST registration for an entity under CIRP within 30 days of his appointment. Since he faced difficulties during the time of lockdown, a notification was passed for an extension. Later, a circular clarified that IRP can obtain GST registration within earlier of two dates, that is either within 30 days of his appointment or by 30th June 2020, which later got extended up to 31st August 2020. The filing of other returns such as GSTR 5, GSTR 6, GSTR 5A, GSTR 7 and GSTR 8, as well as the forms such as ITC 04, CMP 02, LUT by exporters, all got extended up to 31st August 2020 without late fees. Apart from GSTR 3B, GSTR 1 from March to June 2020 got extended by way of a conditional late fee waiver. In other words, the late fee will not be charged if taxpayers have filed their monthly or quarterly GSTR 1 returns for the periods in column 2 on or before the dates mentioned in the last column. For more details about the various clarifications given in these circulars, please visit the page link given in the description box below. If you found this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.